everyone, and welcome to this video. Today I will gonna renovate the building or the house that I made in the live stream I've been doing on Twitch and YouTube. I had plans of expanding it to add a dining room and expand to another bedroom, which is gonna be a butler's bedroom. And first of all, I want to start up and make a wider entrance, and for that I had to open up the objects on mod cheat rather, and to be able to move stuff more properly and do it a bit more like the way I liked it. And well, the front I wanted to expand a bit further to make it a bit bigger, so it didn't look too small and crampy when the house is going to be expanded, because I've already thought it looked a bit too small, the entrance. So making it two more blocks to the left and right, and make it more like a bigger square in the total, I thought would look better. And I did that, and then I started on the roof, which I'm gonna have a bit troubles with, but I really do like this custom content I'm using for the ceiling to give a bit more Victorian style. I think it is actually coming from a previous The Sims games, like The Sims 3, I think, mansion and garden stuff or something like that, I think it's called. I think it's really cool and fits really perfectly to this kind of style of building, this kind of gothic, kind of vampire lair building, like it is supposed to be. But I did have a little problems actually placing it, and I tried to find different solutions, just like they didn't want to fit into the last squares, and I tried to find different solutions, tried to set another ceiling as a, or floor to place it on, but no, they didn't help at all. And I just tried to form out the shape first and do what I got, how I wanted to look, kind of. I want to fix it soon, and I didn't just do some of the kind of fencing on top to make it more like, yeah, Victorian. Well, not really Victorian, but yeah, gothic-ish. And then I found a solution for it. I had to make the first the top floor rather one ceiling higher, and then kind of replace all those, delete and replace, and then finally worked. I could place all those tiles the way I wanted them. And now it just looked completely the way I wanted it. And I was like, oh, that looks great. And then I just realized the window that I'm using down the top floor just looks too small and crappy. I wanted bigger, but I can't really increase the size of it. But then I found that there was a one window is actually the same kind of style, but in a bigger version. So I was like, oh, great, perfect. So after that, I decided to widen the building itself, and also moving the sort of hallway or the entrance where you come in gets a bit wider, both on the right side as well, because it looked like so small, tiny, and cramped when it was only one tile wide. And then I kind of moved about the kitchen a bit to make it a bit more efficient, because it was quite a big room, but it wasn't really efficient and it just didn't feel right. And then I also managed to form out to how I wanted the dining room. So thereafter, I kind of placed up different kind of tables in the kind of styles I was looking for, and then that's the way I kind of do stuff. I look for stuff that I kind of like, and then after I like think about it and like place with chairs and see which one would suit the best and which one is the kind of style I want to go for. So I went to a different kind of black tables, and that was like kind of gothic-ish. And thereafter, placing some chairs, see which chair would fit with what, and what in the end result would look the best, in my opinion. So I found a pair of really cool chairs. Most of them was actually from the new Vampire pack that came, and because that one is actually, yeah, the most fitting. If it is a Vampire Lair coming in from the Vampire pack to fit into the house, and so I kept moving about the chairs and seeing what is the best, and I was like saying, yeah, this table and these chairs are the greatest ones, or that's the one that I think fits the best here. And thereafter, I kind of want to move about the bathroom a bit, just make it a bit better, and then expanding the bedroom. I wasn't really sure how I'm going to do this, because they kind of wanted to have the other bedroom up there, and I was like, I'll solve it in a minute. I just kind of finished up the balcony on the top floor where the bedroom, the master bedroom is, and then place a doorway, kind of open one, and just fill up the wall, so just the same color, and then deciding thereafter what kind of wallpaper should I use in the dining room. And I kind of like this red one, and then I was like, but then in the living room, doesn't really fit with both having red, so I'm gonna go with some other different color in the living room. I think I ended up with a wooden one. Yeah, this is the one I went for, I think. And then deciding for flooring, which flooring I should do. I want to go for something with a really cool pattern-ish. Something dark brownish or something like that. And I thought and filled it about, and I think I at last found something I thought great. And basically going through all the flooring I had, and also in the living room, seeing if there was anyone I found that was good or great that would fit into an overall. But in the living room, I couldn't really go for a pattern one because it would look too clunky and too much, you know. So there I had to go for something more simple. And it's just the dark flooring I had right now, it just looked too dark, even for being a vampire there. So I looked around if I could find something more subtle, maybe patterned, but I couldn't really find one. The most of the ones that I thought was subtle was just too bright in the color, too. So it's just, I just feel about looking through the different floorings I had, and I think I just went for a simple wooden floor, just a bit brighter, a bit more brownish in the color. Yeah. So let's see. It's just a lot of different flooring, and I think I went for that one in the end. So it's like a little pattern, but not too much. And then I was like, okay, I'll just extend this hallway on the top floor so I can make a second bedroom there. I think I actually made it. I'm not too sure if I made it smaller. Yeah, I actually think I did. I did the dining room and the bedroom, that's going to be the butler's bedroom, smaller. So now I'm just moving about stuff and just to a way that I think it looked better. Moving about stuff. Adding some lights. Just to make it easier to fill out furniture in there later. And yeah, there we go. I made it smaller. And just because otherwise it would stick out too much, in my opinion. And I don't think the butler needs that much of a big bedroom. Sound like a horrible employer. So I was trying to find something, a kind of dark wallpaper that is not too dark, and I kind of really didn't find a neat neutral one that wasn't dark, so I just ended up going for that one. I was like, it will have to do. And I found a bed frame that would fit, that looked alright for a butler to use. I think I went for another, kind of sheet. And then a bedside table, fitting one with about the same color. That's the one I went for. And then I was trying to go with this kind of, so I had to go with that one because I wanted to have a wider one, but I couldn't really find one in the same kind of color that fitted great, so I just went for that one. And now I wanted to build a door from the kitchen into the dining room, basically for the chef to come and deliver the food while everyone is already sitting down, kind of ish. Now placing out the windows, moving them about, and to make it a bit better. Also moving curtains, fixing the wallpaper. There we go. I wanted to make it more better, even spread out the windows. And then I also wanted to make this kind of tower in the end of the building too, to give some more variation to the building, because it looked so boring when it's just like a square area. So I moved stuff about. So the bedroom, the bathroom, I mean, went a bit bigger. I moved the stuff about, and I will also replace those later. Just for the basic shape right now. And expanding the walls, this roof, it just didn't look right. And I couldn't really get it to work really good either. But, yeah. Either I had to do like, I did something like that. I tried to experiment, trying to see if I could make it work better, but it didn't look good at all. Because I couldn't get it to line up then in the middle, where the notches or whatever to call it. So then I made a ceiling similar to what I had in the front porch, and just do the same in the back, basically. Even though it's a smaller one, but still kind of same style. That's what I wanted to go for. To give those little towers. I like towers. I always want to have a tower at some point. When I grow up, in my own castle, I'm going to have towers. So placing out the windows, more of this new tower that I made, and then you move the windows more evenly, that looks more better. I decided I'll go for bigger ones in the middle, just to get some variation. Not to have it the same and dull and boring. And moving the windows again. And then curtains, of course. And then I decided, I want to do something different there. I want to kind of do the door down to the basement, or the stairs down to the basement, which is actually where my human catalyst for my vampires. I wanted to kind of make it a bit hidden away, that entrance, and just... So I moved the stairs, and then decided to make just like a hidden away or a more subtle entrance there. So, moving about the stuff, taking away the other fence that I had, so it's coming up the ladder, and then just moving about the stuff, and putting on some lights, because I can't have it too dark, and I really like this kind of candle lights, and this, mostly I go for them in this build, and then I decided to change the curtains in the living room, because I thought those ones I was using were too simple, and so I went for these ones. I thought they fit quite good into the room, actually, even though the edge is like, I wanted to go for the bigger one because it's a bigger window, but it didn't fit because it clipped through the wall, so I just went for the smaller one anyway, and it worked quite fine. And then I went some curtains through the entrance, just to make it a bit spooky, so you can kind of imagine yourself sitting in a living room and just put down the curtains to have really private dinner-ish, so you can feel more private in there. So I really liked that. And then I decided, let's see, I wanted to change the wallpapers in the kitchen too. Because they were too modern, in my opinion, the black, the dark grey tiles, I thought it was too modern, so I wanted to go for something more subtle, or more, gothic, so I was like, maybe some bricks of some sort could work out, and I think I went for some dark grey ones. Yeah, that's the one I went for, this one. I was like, oh, those looks perfect. So I was like, now I need to change the flooring at some point too, but maybe I already did that, change the flooring in the kitchen. I think I already did that. Now, I want to change the kitchen, because that's what I want to do. I want to change most of the rooms to look a bit better, because I had some money now, and now I can actually do something, and not just go for the cheapest possible in my house. So I went for this... Sandrajeva. I don't know. I can't speak French. I really like this style though. This like dark wooden counters with this dark grey tiles, or this grey beige tiles. And then we're going for custom content fridge. I went for as well. This matches the counters. It took me a while to find it. There it is. And I was like, oh, that looks great. And I'm finding a stove. That one is my favorite when it comes to this kind of builds. And now going for over counters, shelves, something. I had a really hard time placing it in the corner. It just didn't want to really place itself. I was like, what's going on? And I just realized it was the wrong color anyway. And then suddenly it worked. So I was like, oh, okay, it works. I won't fiddle with it anymore. And then I just like, it looks really cool to like fence in the oven like that. So put this little kind of, it's actually supposed to be for a fridge fence of contained a normal fridge if you would use that, but I thought it looked really great above the stove, so that's what I went for in the end, and just different styles on the cupboards, and go for sink that would look subtle but also like kind of gothic. Then going for some more light in the room. And then trying to find some clutters, and that's I'm really bad at finding clutters. I'm really bad at it, decorating and stuff. I really like those pans hanging from the ceiling, but they kind of block the view from the kitchen too when you're playing in the kitchen. So I ended up not going for them, even if I do like them. And so I just went through the catalog, see if I could find something. I don't even know, some stuff I kind of found and was like, oh, they look really cool, like place in another room because I want to place it somewhere else at some point, but some of the things I actually placed out just randomly, I just completely forgot about that I placed, and so I just found some little clutter at least to make the kitchen a bit less boring. So yeah, I'm going for those again. It's like, it looks kind of cool, but at the same time, it takes so much place. And it's just trying to find clutters that isn't too big. It's just, yeah, it's just. But then at least I found something to place in the living room, at least. Kind of, how do you say it? A place bookshelf? plate shelf? I don't know what to call it, really. Then going back to clutter, trying to find something. Can I please place some flowers of some sort? I was like, oh, it looked quite cool. Some aloe vera, or whatever it could be. And then changing out the bar stools to a nice color. I was like, oh, this blue one's quite cool. Get some little bit of color into the room at least. And let's see. I was like thinking maybe I should play a bench outside or something on the outside, like a fountain or something. And I didn't go for it. I was just, I don't know. Couldn't find anything. And now the next project I had that took quite a long time, which was trying to find some kind of cool placement for carpets on the ground. I wanted to go for, you know, in like castle, this red carpet that you can go to and over and shit. And I just couldn't really find anything good. I was like, these ones are kind of cool. And I couldn't get them to line up in a really good way when I placed them. I just tried to, because it's different size of that carpet, and I tried to line it up, but it just didn't want to go in a good way. I want to have a kind of a walkway from the entrance into the dining room directly. So it's just, I always ended up with some corner being uncovered, or the carpets didn't line up good, and it's just. So I've fiddled around like this for quite a while with different sizes and moving them back and forth. It's didn't want to move get really what I wanted it. So I think I ended up making my own carpet and in the end, bit flooring, and I thought it went all right. I was at that point. I was like, ah, it will have to do. I used to my own carpet and it looks good. Just moving because. There was like good, but then it clipped through to the basement and this didn't look good either. So, yeah. Kept on moving these carpets around. Gonna take a while. Until I realize it's pointless. Oh well. Otherwise, I really do like those carpets. It's a really nice, subtle pattern that's. Otherwise, if you're just gonna do a straight line. They're quite easy to line up, but if you want to do like that in a corner, like it moves around, it doesn't really want to line up in a good way. So, I mean, that was the best I could do, but it just didn't look good either. So then I started thinking about, I do some carpet flooring instead by myself, just trying to find a nice, cool red color. Yeah. I think I went for the one from the Vampire Pack after all. It's dark red. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. I'm placing it out. But I don't know if it was that color I went for in the end. Oh, it was a brighter one. But I think it was that one. Just rotating to make it look good. Yeah, and then I removed the other carpets. So like, oh, this is it. This will have to do. Then maybe about the flowers I have in the front porch and in the front yard. Placing some dirt to mix a bit more. Underneath them to make it a bit more, how they say it, variation in the ground, so it doesn't look like they're completely placed in the ground, so at least it looks like they've been growing into the ground. And now I was trying to decide what kind of walkway should I use. And I was like, I'll just go for these ones. They're quite simple, easy. And yeah, once again, fountains, trying to fiddle about with them. And now placing out some more vegetation, just to make it a bit more, how to say it, living. I was like, oh, that one looks great in there back there. I just move it there. Most of them are too big, in my opinion. They're either taking too much space or just too high up. I just wanted to have some, like low-laying grass or some. They're like too much living flowers are placed out. I wanted to have some more dead flowers or more like graveyard-ish like. But I couldn't find any good ones similar to that, so I was just like, I play out some flowers just to have some variation here. Just trying to find something that looks good. I kind of like those flowers. I was like, ooh, red. Oh, looks great. And I was like, move them there. And yeah, like, can I do something with stone? Nope, whoop, nope, they're too enormous, all of them. And then I realized that the climbing vines I had on the wall had been moved, or had gotten, I don't know, when I'm moving about the windows or something, they had gotten deleted by mistake or something. So I had to kind of replace them in a cool way. I really like those in this kind of build, because it gives it some, how do I say, feeling of the house being old and, not really not taken care of, but gives a more spooky feeling to it. And some ceiling or roof decoration, just to give some variation to it, everything. I really like those gargoyles looking down from the roof. And then I realized, oh yeah, I have a, open fireplace, so I should place a chimney of some sort, a really cool looking one. That's not too big either, so I think I went for quite a tiny one. I think I went for that one in the end, because I didn't want it too obvious either, so I went for that one. It didn't take too much space, and then I had to change the ceiling color to match more the decoration ceiling I had on the towers, more similar color. And let's see, yeah, trying to fiddle around with the ceiling again, but I couldn't find any good solution to it. And so I went on direct with moving some stuff around. What did it? Yeah, move the organ. And I wanted to change the bookcase as well. I thought it was too simple. Even if I like it, it was too simple in the and it was too dark to fit really into the room. And I couldn't find it was the same with the piano, but I couldn't find a better color for it. So that one had to stay. And I thought, I want to change the interior of the master bathroom. And I decided to go for one of the custom contents I have, which you can basically make your own shower and bathtub. You basically combine it yourself, which I think is quite a cool idea. And I wanted to go for something like brownish colors in that room. Not too dark, because the bathroom is dark as it is, with dark walls. So, and of course I had to go for some toilet to match it, and some sink as well. Let's see, which one did I go for at the end? I think I went for that one that I'm currently having there showing. And then some mirror matching it. Then I thought I'll change the other bathroom as well, might as well. And I thought, like, that's one I'm gonna go for dark red-black from the vampire pack. Go for that one, the whole set. Just make it simple, black and red in that room. let's see. I'm placing out the same mirror from the same pack. And also the little guest bathroom, or the bottom floor toilet. Change it a bit. Let's see, I wanted to change the floorings in most of the rooms as well to some more variation, because every room had the same floor on the top floor, and I thought, let's have some more variation to this. It needs more. So I was trying to fiddle around with different floorings, and some different ones are quite cool one pattern, one for the master bedroom. And then we went for different kind of brown ones into the room's going to be for the butler, and then some dark brownish, I think I went for in this little red bedroom. The vampire sister's bedroom. So, just some dark brown and some grey-ish into the kids' room. Then I wanted to change the walls on the master bathroom, and I was looking for black colors mainly. Black. Because, it's a vampire lair, and I look for different kind of bricks, but it didn't look too good. But then finally, I found some really cool looking one. Let's see. It was really subtle, but really cool looking anyway. Let's see, that's the one, yeah. And then I want to change it, the flooring as well, so it matches. Like for black, I was like, oh, that one looks great into that room. And then move, directly go to, quickly go to the other bathroom and place that flooring that I found. And then just do some other black one. And then thinking, now I need some red walls into this bathroom because to make it more red-ish. So look for some red wallpaper. And then like, oh, that one looks great. Perfect. And let's see, what did I do now? Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, curtains. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to place out some more curtains. Just to put something more on the wall so it doesn't look too boring. And find someone that would fit and doesn't look too like too much or too little. I found some for the child's room. I just need to find something for the red room. I couldn't really find one that looked good. Either was like colours didn't really fit or it was something else. I was just, had to think about that for a second. So, let's see. I think I just went for, yeah, that one. It was a bit too much, but I couldn't find a better option. And I was thinking, should I use some curtains to the little master bathroom? I don't think I went for any after all. I was like, nah, I don't bother. And then I kind of wanted to place some carpets underneath the bedrooms, or underneath the beds in the bedrooms, just to, you know, when you step out of the bed in the early morning, and the floor is cold, you kind of want to step on a nice warm carpet instead of directly on the cold floor. So that's what I thought I was going to do for my, even if they're vampires, they have feelings too, okay? Trying to find some really nice purplish color that would fit into the room. I think I actually went for standard The Sims 4 carpet in the end, into the master bedroom at least, that one I think I went for in the end. It kind of fit the best into the room. I wanted to look if I could find something else, but I couldn't. Now you move the red one to the other room, and into the little children's room. I just like, I wanted to do something more different. I wanted a bluish color, but I wanted a round one, but it just colors didn't really fit in the end, but I just, and it will have to do, I think I said, it will have to do. And then I wanted to make a walkway with carpets on the top floor too, make it line up quite nice. Something, I kind of really like carpets, something I really do, which is really hard for me to use in real life because I have cats, and yeah. Carpets love cat hair. You just keep gathering it up, like soaks it up. So all my carpets I have at home with myself in the living room is full of cat hair. And I'm trying to use a plastic rubber hand glove to clean off the cat hair, but it's just, it looks really great doing like technique, but it just keep coming back. So it's like a pointless fight, it feels like sometimes. Let's see, what was I doing now in-game? Yeah, I was upgrading the bedrooms. Upgrading. Upgrading frames, upgrading the night tables, and I went for that one. That bed frame, I think it looks great into that little room. And I was like, ooh, a clock. I really need a, like, old grandpa clock into the living room downstairs. And I was like, well, should I use a little clock above the fireplace? And I was like, nah, there was no good looking one anyway, so I just went for the big one. Then I was thinking, should I put some paintings up maybe? Looking at different kind of paintings. I kind of like that one. I love the pattern, but the frame didn't fit in any other room than the dining room, so it will have to do there. I was thinking any other paintings I could place out. Nah, couldn't find anything, so looking at more decorations, anything I can place out just to make the house more living, all the or how to say it, more decorated, or how to say it. I think I found something later on too. Let's see, yeah, that bird I really liked. It was like a raven looking downwards. I was like, I put it in that corner, it looks good. I found another one, it's basically the same one, but like a dark colour, but I kind of like the white one more. So then I went back to cluttering, into the kitchen, and just to I really liked that one. It felt too big there, so I just placed it on the next to the stove instead, and then some knives, because you need knives. If you're gonna do cooking, you need knives. And I found the smaller one, I was like, ah, it will. Now the big one will have to do. So, then I found this little sword and shield. I was like, oh, that's really cool. I need to find a good spot for it, but just couldn't really find a really good spot for it. I was like, hmm. There was like the best place I could, place I could find for it, behind the stairs and so. So I was like, it will have to do. Then carpets, more carpets. I want to place more carpets. Some nice color to, just to give some more decoration into the room, some more, not just so simple and boring. And then I wanted to exchange the computer desk, or working desk. I'm having a kind of a typewriter CC mod instead of a computer. It works like a computer, it is a computer, but it looks like a typewriter. If it's more into the house, aesthetically seen, in my opinion, because it would place a super modern computer there, it just look completely out of place. So that's why I wanted to go for that. And then just move down the lamps so they are about the same level. And then move them about so it looks more better in general. Then move the potty to the bendy children's room. Let's see, I wanted to place a trash cans. Let's see. Then I wanted to go for a carpet into the master bathroom. I think I'm about to be done soon in this little video. I'm just trying to find a nice bathroom rug. Then I signed, oh, I really like this rug from a Vampire Stuff Pack, but I couldn't find a good location for it, so I just went for a simple blue carpet, I think, in the end, in the bathroom. Just to, yeah, have something at least, some decoration of some sort. And, yeah, that one. That's the one I went for in the end. And I was really kind of happy with the result. And this is basically how I ended up with this renovation. And I was quite pleased with it. Like the different floors and everything. And I hope you guys really enjoy it. Thank you everyone for watching. I'll see you guys next time.